Forget Madeleine Albright, Richard Holbrooke, or Zbigniew Brzezinski. What about Ayman al-Zawahiri, al-Qaeda's number two, advising President-elect Barack Obama on foreign policy, courtesy of As-Sahab, the media arm of al-Qaeda? Well, al-Qaeda voted McCain, as everybody knows. They wanted a Bush 3 mandate, but they lost.
الذي أود أن أنبهك له هو أن ما أعلنته من أنك ستتفاهم مع إيران وتسحب جنودك من العراق لترسلهم لأفغانستان هو سياسة كتب عليها الفشل قبل أن تولد.
Al-Zawahiri and the historical al-Qaeda leadership, they may be in disarray, of course, much more than the US neocons for that matter. They know that ideologically Obama may, if he does not remain a prisoner of the war on terror framework. And if he successfully brands the US, rebrands the US worldwide, Obama may deliver a mortal blow to al-Qaeda in terms of al-Qaeda's recruiting power among young, desperate and disenfranchised Muslims and the so-called white Moors, European Muslims. Plus, there's Obama's proposed surge in Afghanistan, coupled with a surge in the Pakistani tribal areas, of course. Obama is dead set to strike where allegedly the historical al-Qaeda leadership is holed up.
تمثل النقيض للأمريكان السود الشرفاء من أمثال مالك الشهباز أو مالكوم إكس رحمه الله. وصدق فيك وفي كولين باول ورايس وأمثالكم قول مالك الشهباز رحمه الله عن عبيد البيت.
You have to read the history of slavery to understand this. There were two kinds of Negroes. There was that old house Negro and the field Negro. And the house Negro always looked out for his master.
Now, what motivates al-Zawahiri to stress that Obama is not Malcolm X? Well, first of all, al-Zawahiri, in Arabic, he says Abid al-Bayt. That means house slave and not house Negro, as it has been translated in the US. There's nothing to suggest that Obama, as the most powerful man on earth, will be a house slave. Al-Zawahiri does not seem to understand that in many levels, apartheid in the US is over. He does not understand that an overwhelming majority of blacks voted for Obama, and at least 50% of white Americans also voted for Obama.
فهي للشعب الأمريكي فأقول له لقد جنيت الهزائم والخسائر من حماقات بوش وعصابته وفي نفس الوقت وجه لك الشيخ أسامة بن لادن حفظه الله رسالة للانسحاب من أراضي المسلمين والكف عن سرقة ثرواتهم والتدخل في شؤونهم فاختر لنفسك ما تشاء وتحمل نتيجة اختيارك وكما تدين تدان.
Here al-Zawahiri has a point. In Iraq, the Muslim world won, but against Western imperialism. The Bush system and the neocons, they were foolish enough to believe that they could invade and try to conquer and occupy the eastern flank of the Arab nation, Iraq, which has always historically resisted imperialism. But al-Qaeda in Iraq is not winning hearts and minds. The real winners in Iraq, they are pro-Iranian Shiites. And al-Qaeda, they are Sunni Wahhabis, they are sectarian to the core. They consider Shiites as apostates. These rantings by al-Zawahiri regarding Iran and Shiites, they mirror his whining in 2006 against Sheikh Nasrallah, when Hezbollah virtually won the war in 2006 against Israel. So what should President-elect Barack Obama make of all this? Well, he has to be very, very careful. Now his soft power all over the Muslim world is immense. If he deploys it wisely, Obama, the community organizer, he can really smash al-Qaeda, the brand and the idea, forever. He can consign it to the dustbin of history. If he doesn't, it's very simple. He'll end up like George W. Bush.
Endless wars, abuse of powers, declining living standards, and the climate change crisis. The stakes couldn't be greater in the US 2008 presidential elections. And with your help, we're moving our news operation to Washington, D.C., where we'll focus on money and corruption. For example, big oil and arms companies shape American economic and foreign policy with far-reaching effects on the lives of ordinary people. With allies in government, trade unions, the media, and in think tanks, They're a hidden hand that controls the commanding heights of American politics. Taking on the industrial military complex is what real change requires. Even former presidents and high administration officials have said so. But corporate television news treats such positions as marginal. Well, we think it's the decisive issue in the coming presidential elections. Uncompromising journalism requires questioning assumption, interrogating structures of wealth and power. Corporate TV news just won't do it. Only a news organization that's truly independent can tackle such issues with courage and tenacity. And we'll take on corporate TV news live. You'll watch TV news with our panel of writers, journalists, scientists, and historians. You'll be able to join in by phone, webcam, chat. Together, we'll discuss and debate what's the real story and take on the myth and the propaganda. But this is only possible if you support us now. We need to prove that a viewer-funded model works. So if you want the real news, we need you now. Please click on the donate button and give generously. Now's the time to decide if you want the real news to thrive.
Your tax-deductible donation makes it possible. Please contribute at therealnews.com.